YouTube, what it do, baby? We are back with another video. Hopefully everybody's having an amazing day or night whenever you're watching this. Warzone, finally, season 3 for both Cold War, Warzone. Hopefully it's the best update we've had or best season that we've had. A lot of content from the roadmap and lots of things that we have seen. Hopefully it all exceeds everybody's standards. I'm not trying to get too happy. I'm trying to stay in that middle ground where I'm just going to wait and see what happens with it, man. Hopefully it's for the better. Hopefully the map's for the better. Hopefully everybody enjoys and has some fun playing this game. That's the main thing, right? But anyway, I'm going to be giving you guys these top 10 weapons to use here in Warzone. Obviously, there's lots of different combinations that you can use. If you want Ghost, Overkill, you guys know the deal when it comes to Warzone. Lots of different things you can run. Secondaries, it just depends. But I'm going to go through I'm going to go through 10 weapons for you and the attachments that do very well and will succeed here in the Warzone battlefield. So I don't want to waste too much of your time. Let's jump right into this class setups, man. Peace. YouTube, here we go, baby. Top 10 weapons, class setups, whatever you want to call it here in Warzone. Obviously, people have preference. It's preference-based. So some of you are going to have different weapons. Maybe I didn't throw in the Growl. Maybe I didn't throw in the M4, the XM4. I don't know. Whatever you guys think. Let me know what you guys think should be in the top 10 if I don't have it already. I know the Cold War MP5. I did not put that in here, which is also a very good weapon. But we're going to jump into this, man. Obviously, some of you may have different attachments, which is completely fine. But if you pick some stuff from mine that you want to implement into your loadouts or class setups, go for it, man. Let me know how it works for you. So I don't want to waste too much time. Let's jump into it. So for the first one is the AMAX. Everybody loves the AMAX, man. It does have a little bit more recoil than some of the other ARs that we've had that have been meta in the game. But once you figure this recoil out, it's just vertical. Nothing crazy about it. It hits harder than most ARs. So I'm gonna jump into this class up for you guys really quick. For the AMAX, we're a monolithic Zodiac barrel, VLK optic sight. You can run holograph or hollow sight if you like as well. Commando foregrip, 45 round mag. So that is for the AMAX. I'm not gonna go through the secondaries, guys. You can have whatever. I'm just going through the main weapon, then you can base your secondary based on the primary weapon that you're gonna be using in the game. Okay. So for the FFAR, this is Booyah's class setup that I took from him. There's one change to it, though. I haven't looked at his loadout recently, so he may have changed it back. But anyway, I run for the agency suppressor for the muzzle, the 19.5 task force barrel. It does have a lot more recoil, but once you figure it out and play with it a while, you guys are going to just shred the lobbies. Just trust me on this, guys. Then we have the Raider stock, better movement speed. We have the 50 round fast mag. If you want to move a little bit quicker, you would just put on the regular 50 round mag. But I've been playing a lot of Rebirth, Rebirth Island Warzone, doing that a lot. So I run the 50 round fast mags just because the engagements are all the time, it seems like. That's why I run that. And I run the Bruiser grip for better movement speed as well. That is for the FFAR. Then we're going to jump down to the AUG. I know this got a nerf, and the recoil is a lot more than what it used to be, but this thing still melts, guys. Once you figure it out, it's just a vertical recoil pattern. It is harder to control, but once you figure it out and use it a lot, this thing is just like the M16. So let's jump into this. So we have the agency silencer. We have the titanium barrel, the axial arms 3x optic, 54-round drum mag, and then we have the field agent foregrip for better for horizontal and vertical recoil. So that is for the AUG. For the Kilo, one of my favorites, man, of all time, the Kilo MP5 meta back in the day. You guys know what I'm talking about. But anyway, man, we have the monolithic. We have the Singard Arms 19.8 Prowler, VLK 3x optic, 60 round mags. And if you want a little bit better movement speed, you can run the 50 round mags. I know back in the day, I was watching some streamers. I forgot who they are to be exact, but they would run the 50 round mag just for the movement speed. So you could do that as well. And we have the Commando foregrip. Can't go wrong with that Commando, man. And then we go down to the M16, which right here I have the agency silencer for the muzzle. I have the strike team barrel. You can run titanium as well for better fire rate. Both of those, I'll just mess it around, but strike team or titanium for the M16. I think I have a class for each. Then we have axial arms 3x, 45 round speed mag. You could have the 45 round regular mag as well. Like I said, I was playing Rebirth, so I was shooting a lot more. Then I have the SVOD speed grip for the M16. Then we go down to the RAM, a very slept on weapon, a very, very good weapon, one of my all-time favorites as well. We have the monolithic FSS Ranger TAC laser, which you could substitute for the VLK optic if you wanted to use it for your long-range engagements. Then we have the Commando foregrip and 50-round mag. So like I said, you could substitute the TAC laser for the VLK or an optic of your choice to make that your long-range engagement weapon, okay? Then we go down to the Car 98, one of my favorite sniper by far. I know it's a little bit weaker than some, but it's my favorite. Monolithic, SingGuard Custom 27.6, TAC Laser, Variable Zoom Scope. And I love the Variable Zoom, some people don't. And then Stippled Grip Tape for better ADS. That is for the car. Then we go down to the Bullfrog. We have the Groove Suppressor. Okay, for the barrel run of the VDV Reinforced Barrel. I did take J-God's class. I think he did have a different barrel. I think he had the Cavalry Lancer because of the bullet velocity, because he does all the testing. I think he had that, but I do prefer the VDV Reinforced Barrel. No stock, better movement speed. You get around a lot quicker. Very close gauge, close range engagements with this weapon. For the ammunition, 65 round mag. You don't really need anything more. If you want to go crazy, you can put the 85 on there, but you more than likely will not need that. Then we have the Bruiser Grip, better movement speed. This thing gets around quick, let me tell you. Okay, and then we have, below that, we have the Psykov pistols. Yes, there was a nerf. Okay, we know that. They nerfed when you had the auto barrel with the dual wield. So, is it still good? Unbelievable. It's still very, very good, guys. There's not really a nerf to it. You can tell a little bit, but up close, in somebody's face, you're still not going to lose a gunfight if you have dual wield. In this class setup right here, I do not have dual wield. I have the single Psykov. That is it. Or Sakov, whatever you want to call it. Okay, I have a single right here, and this is the best class up for the single. The only thing you would change right here would be taking off the carabin stock and putting on dual wield. Okay, so I have monolithic Sorokin 144mm auto, 5MW laser for better hip fire, carabin stock, and 8-round drum mag. Okay, that is for the Psykov pistol. Then the last one is the MAC-10. Obviously, it's still a very good weapon. People run it a lot still. I think it's still going to be viable, obviously, in Season 3 coming up. So, or Season 3 right now. So, anyway, we have Agency Suppressor, Reinforced Heavy Barrel. I know a lot of people run different things for this. Serpent Wrap for the grip, 53-round Fast Max, and then Striker Grip for better movement speed. So, like I said, a lot of these can change. They are preference-based. Whatever you feel comfortable rocking, go ahead and try that. But if you do want to steal some of mine, feel free, man, and let me know how it works for you. But that is all I have in today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. These are 10 weapons that will make you shred lobbies. Okay, I wouldn't tell you that if I haven't done it myself. So these are 10. Let me know if you rock any of these. Try them out. You know, shoot me a message on Twitter, comment on YouTube, whatever you guys want to do. But hopefully you guys have an amazing day. Hopefully you have an amazing Season 3 of Warzone and Black Ops Cold War. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.